In this video, I'm going to show you how you can use simple editing tools to remove unwanted objects from this photo. But this isn't a specially selected example designed to be easy and give good results. It's a typical problem photo you'll run into all the time. Now, the most important step before we start the repair is to plan it. With this image, we'll split the editing into three sections. The first fixes the area on the right of the frame to remove the crane and the signpost. We can then copy this area of the image and use it to repair the left side of the frame. Then finally, we'll remove the rest of the unwanted objects from the right side. Be sure to watch the entire example because I'll be sharing tips with you throughout. I'll start by adding a new layer to my image to make the repair onto. I want to use a new layer for each section of the repair to help organise my editing. I'll do this by selecting Layer and then New Layer from the Affinity Photo menu. As you can see, the new layer is then created in the Layers Studio panel. It's probably a good idea to rename these layers, but for this demonstration, I'm not going to bother. Next, I'll magnify the area that I want to repair so that I can see what I'm doing as I work. Notice that I'm working at a higher magnification, typically between 200% and 300%, as this makes it easier to create a convincing repair. For the first repair, I'll be removing the crane, and I'll use the impacting brush tool for this. I'll also make sure that I have it set to sample the current layer and below when making the repair. Now I can paint over the parts of the crane to remove it section by section. This is a very easy repair to make using the impacting brush tool, although I don't expect it to be a perfect repair with some of the larger areas. The reasons that I'm working on sections of the crane at a time is to help make a better repair. The brush seems to be better at replacing small sections than larger ones. I'll also resize my brush as necessary to make painting over sections easier. Having made the bulk of the repair with the impacting brush tool, I can see a few areas that haven't been well repaired. I can clean those up now using the healing brush tool. After selecting the healing brush tool from the tools palette, I'll resize the brush and take a sample point. You can do this by holding down the Option or Alt key on your keyboard and then clicking. What I can then do is work my way around the clouds, repairing any areas that didn't work well with the impacting brush. What you may not realise is that by taking a sample point that contains detail, the brush will copy the sample detail and then try to blend that into the repair. Watch what happens when I take a sample of the roof and then paint over another area. Notice how this creates a cleaner repair as I'm working, although I still need to work on small sections of the area at a time. Doing this allows me to align any detail that's being copied into the new area, making for a better blend. If the repair doesn't work cleanly initially, I can resample and continue to apply the healing brush to that area. Sometimes though, it's definitely better to undo the change and start again. You can do this using the shortcut keys Command and Z to undo the last change. Now I can copy sections of the window frame to remove the areas where this cable has cut across it. After that, it's a simple job to just copy sections of the wall and the window itself and use this to cover over the cables. After a little work, I can complete a very good repair of this area. From time to time, I'll also check the image at 100% magnification. It's very easy to get carried away with trying to make the image look perfect when you're working at higher magnifications. Now I'm going to add another new layer to help me remove the signpost and the ticket sign. This keeps the repairs separate from the crane. As before, I'll magnify the image and zoom into the area that I want to repair. I'll continue working with the healing brush, resizing it so that I can work precisely. As I work, I continue to resample from areas that look like they'll make a good repair, which also helps to avoid the problem of repeating patterns becoming obvious. When I get to a larger object with the healing brush, the repair isn't very convincing. The healing brush works best with smaller objects that you can completely paint over. A better alternative for this type of work is the clone brush. The clone brush works like the healing brush, except that it doesn't try to blend what's been copied into the surrounding area. Because of this, you can achieve a more accurate repair, although it does become obvious and easy to see. You therefore need to paint with more accuracy and consider where to sample from. You need to think about how you want the area to look once it's repaired. It's a bit like planning lots of mini repairs as you work. Notice as I repair the area of the sign to remove it, I'm careful to sample the edges of the wall and to line those up with the areas that I want to replace. Also, watch out for areas of repeating pattern which are easy to create using the clone tool. Notice that I'm removing the entire area of the sign and the shadows to replace them with detail that you might expect to see there. Because the detail doesn't look out of place, your brain accepts it as part of the original image. And that's the secret to making a good repair when removing something. It doesn't need to replicate what's behind the object you're removing. It just needs to fit into the scene. When it comes to removing the ticket sign, I'm going to copy the foliage from around the area to hide it. As before, I'm going to add a new layer for this part of the repair, as a lot could go wrong. As the ticket sign is a reasonably large area, I'll try using the patch tool to select the area. After selecting the area to replace, I'll find a suitable area to use for the repair. Once I've selected the area to use for the repair, you can see that it looks good, but it doesn't really blend into the area. To improve the repair, I'll switch now to using the healing brush. Now I can sample other areas of foliage and use those to blend the patch into the scene. Notice that I don't sample from a single area because of the problem with repeating patterns. And here's what the repair looks like if I turn the layer off and on. Now when I zoom out to 100% magnification, you can't spot the repairs and they appear totally natural. The next area of the image to repair is the lower left corner. Here you can see an army vehicle and a couple of tourists that we want to remove. This is a more complex repair because the army vehicle covers up both the tower and the building in the background. If you visit my website, you'll find a tutorial where I explain an alternate approach to the repair we'll be doing in this video. I'll include a link to that in the YouTube video description. For the first part of the repair in this video, we'll clone the pillar on the outer edge of the tower and extend it to the bottom of the frame. As before, let's start by adding a new layer to the image to make the repair to. After that, we can select the clone tool from the tool's palette. Now I'll take a sample point from further up the column and use this to clone the column to the bottom of the frame. As I move down, the additional section of column now covers the edge of the army vehicle. I'm also leaving a small edge that looks like a gate so that it finishes off the edge of the railings nicely. After creating the edge of the tower using the cloned column, I can see brush strokes in the stone. To fix these, I'll switch to the healing brush tool and use this to brush over these areas. By working with a small healing brush and copying sections of the stonework, I can line up the areas nicely to create a clean repair. For the second part of this repair, I want to remove the rest of the army vehicle from the left corner of the image. The easy solution is to copy another section of the image and use it to cover up the unwanted area. A good candidate for this is the bottom right of the frame, which we've already cleared up. This is a good example of why it's important to plan out a repair in advance. If we hadn't cleaned up that area first, we wouldn't be able to use it now. I'll start by selecting the area that I want to copy using the lasso tool. The lasso tool has different modes which you can access with the icons in the toolbar. I want to use the polygon mode to draw this selection. It's great for selecting large areas of an image with straight edges or where you don't need to worry about fine details. Each time I click, Affinity Photo adds a new point to outline the area. Then when I click back on the first point, it closes the area and converts it to a selection. Now I can select Edit and then copy Merged from the menu. I'm using this because what you see on screen is a combination of different layers. It's only by merging them that I'm going to be able to create a copy of the area as it looks now. Then I can use the paste option in the edit menu to duplicate the section. You can see the new layer in the Layers Studio panel. We don't need the selection anymore, so I'll deselect it in the menu. Then I can choose the Move tool in the Tools palette and use it to drag the copy image over to the left of the frame. Currently the image is the wrong way round for the left side of the frame because of the direction the trees are sloping. An easy way to flip it around is clicking the side drag handle with the Move tool and dragging it over to the right. Now I can size and move the image copy into position in the bottom corner. Whilst this covers up the unwanted army vehicle, it also covers the edge of the tower. I'm going to fix this now by adding a layer mask, but I'm not going to immediately paint on it. Instead, I'm going to reduce the layer opacity so that I can see the edge of the tower. Now I can use the lasso tool to select the edge of the tower, which is going to help me paint the mask. After making the selection, I can set the layer opacity back to 100%. Then, using a black paintbrush, I can paint onto the layer mask inside the selection. This reveals the edge of the tower, making the copied section of the image look like it's in the background. Now I can deselect the active selection in the menu. I can also try painting along the top edge of the mask, but this doesn't appear to blend well with the sky. Instead, I'll repair the area now using the healing brush tool. As before, let's create a new empty layer for the repair. I'll then sample from the clouds in another part of the sky and make the repair onto the new layer. I just need to be careful not to get too near to the edge of the columns because it can smudge the areas. This is something that happens when you use the healing brush because it spreads out the area to try to blend it. When I zoom out to see the entire image, the area of the repair on the left appears believable and as if it's always been there. It's tempting to leave the image like this, but it's often the fine details in a repair that make the difference. If we magnify the lower right of the photo, we can see there's still an unwanted bin and the remains of a signpost. As with the other repairs, the best way to tackle this is in small sections, working at a high magnification. I'll start by adding a new layer to make the repair onto. Then, using the healing brush, I'll sample the grass below the chain fence. After that, I can paint over the length of the chain to remove it. For the next set of repairs, I'll magnify the image to 300% to make it easier to work on the detail. Where the chain cuts across the grass and pavement, I'll sample from a similar area along the edge of the grass. Now I can line up the healing brush copy so that it makes a clean repair before clicking to apply it. Whilst I could continue with the healing brush, it won't be easy because of the amount of detail in the area. It'll be much better to work with the clone tool to select and copy small areas to build up the repair. I'll reduce the size of my brush using the left square bracket key on my keyboard and select a sample point from the railings. I'm going to use this to replace the remaining part of the signpost where it's covering the railings. The key to making this repair work is to pick a sample point where the horizontal rail crosses the vertical railings and then line that up carefully. After that, I can paint up and down the railings with the brush to replace the long section of the pole. Then when I reach the next horizontal rail, I'll take a new sample to copy and apply that. Notice how this builds up the railings and makes them look completely realistic. The tricky part comes where the post cuts across the pathway, as it's difficult to sample anything with the correct angle. There are techniques you could use to get around this, but I want to keep this video simple. Instead, what I'm going to do is sample and repair very small areas at a time so that it's a bit like painting in new detail but using the clone tool. Now I'll try to gradually build up the edge of the path to remove the top of the bin. Again, I'm working on small areas to build up the replacement stonework gradually. If I make any mistakes or the area doesn't look good, I'll just use the undo keyboard shortcut of Command and Z. If you're using a PC, that's Ctrl and Z. Now I could take a little more care with this, but it won't look too bad because I'm working at 300% magnification. I also need to keep the time down on this video to keep it short. After I've made a rough repair to remove the top of the bin, I'll work on removing the chain from the fence. Everything I'm doing is using the clone tool, but it's possible to also paint in detail using the paintbrush. Personally, I prefer using the clone tool as it copies real texture and colour variations from the image. I always think there's less chance of this appearing fake than just trying to paint in colour with a brush. Now I'll copy a section of the bottom of the fence post and use it to repair the post that was behind the bin. When you need to build something up or replace it, look for similar areas or objects in the image you can copy. It will shortcut and save you time. Let's now remove the rest of the bin that's covering the grass using the clone tool. I'll just take a sample from another area of similar grass and then paint over the bin. As I work, I'll resample as I need to. But because I keep sampling from the same area of grass that I've just replaced, I can see that I'm creating a repeating pattern. When you spot this kind of problem, an easy fix is to use the healing brush. Simply sample another area of grass and then paint over the problems. Just be careful where you place the sample point and you change it from time to time. Then, as you paint, the repeating pattern just vanishes. Now when we look at the image at 100%, you don't see the areas we've just fixed. They appear to be part of the image. Finally, I'll group the different repair layers into a folder. I can then hide the folder to compare the starting and finished image. Although I've only used basic tools for the repair in this video, it's been possible to create a realistic image free from unwanted objects. Now, something that I forgot to share with you at the start of the video is that you can download this image from my website so that you can practice along with the video. I'll put a link to this in the YouTube video description below. Being able to replace anything in an image is an important photo editing skill, and you should take time to practice and learn it. The other skill that you must learn is creating selections, and that's why you need to watch this video next. I share one of the secrets behind the selection brush in Affinity Photo, which is hardly ever mentioned. When you know this, you'll find the brush much easier to use. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to share this video.